Welcome everyone to Spartan Hockey. Tonight's against Minichog. Big game tonight. I'm Alex Maserati. Alongside with me is
Jack Gagnon.
And it's going to be a really good game tonight. Last game, Griffin Trace scored 2 goals. And Xavier Ficini scored 2-2. And we're hoping to see better from other players tonight. So it's going to be a good game.
Minichog just came back from a 8-0 win, I believe, against West Springfield.
Wow.
So their offense is pretty good.
Yeah. Good. Minichog's got a Super 7. Cam Mariani. Phenomenal last year for his freshman year on varsity. He's first line alongside with Anthony Pidio. So it's going to be a good game. East Long Meadow yesterday, or not yesterday, but last week went against Agawam. That was a really good game. It was a really good start to the season.
And yeah, McKenna Nama, a good goalie too. Scored 4 goals off of him.
Yeah, very good. A nice addition this year was goalie Jack O'Brien to the East Long Meadow. That was a very good addition to the team. All right, starting faceoff. And goes towards Minichog. And ice down to East Long Meadow. Faceoff on Minichog's end. Minichog wins it. Minichog going up for the puck. East Long Meadow's Paul Alamo clears it, but it's back into East Long Meadow's end. Big hit on the boards by Minichog's number 9 on East Long Meadow's number 15. Pass in the front for Minichog. Here comes East Long Meadow going up. And clears it. Battle on the boards for the puck. Minichog tries to dump it. But number 10, I think that's Zach Martin for East Long Meadow, still battling for it. Clears it out, passes in the front. Deflected by Minichog. Minichog going up. Minichog offsides. Sorry, number 10 was Ben Wasky earlier. East Long Meadow wins the faceoff, dumps it. Minichog gets the puck back to East Long Meadow, dumps it back in there, back in Minichog's end. Turned over by East Long Meadow. Passes it to Jacob Bates. To the center, but Minichog gets it. Big race to the puck in the front. And just missed. Just wide of the net, Minichog shot. Here comes number 10, Ben Wasky. Clears it. Dumps it into the Minichog end. East Long Meadow with the shot. And saved by the goalie.
Bouncing puck, always tough to save.
Yep.
Good job right there.
You never know what's going to happen with that. Bad bounces on the ice, you know, it depends on the game. Face off, Minichog's end. And it goes to Minichog. So far, I think all face offs have been on Minichog's favor. East Long Meadow with the puck, battled on the board. Here comes Benwoski. Passes in the middle. But no shot. Minichog with a puck. Tries to get it out. But it's a back and forth to Isong Middle and Minichog. Confusion with the puck. But Isong Middle gets it back. And Minichog's going to Isong Middle's end. Tries to self-pass, see if he'll get it on the boards. Hard check, but number 17, Zach Martin goes up, but he clears it, dumps it into Minichog's end. Minichog with the puck, taking their time, but Isong Middle gets it. Number 7, Jacob Bates passes it to, believe that's Mike Leahy. Dumps it in there, and shot by Isong Meadow, but nice save by Minichog.
Minichog has been pretty much defensive so far.
Yeah. Minichog with the puck, tries to center it, shot, saved by Jack O'Brien.
They've been fanning on their shots too.
Yeah. Seems both ends are struggling with controlling the puck, trying to create a flow, but it's just not there yet. Face off on Isong Middle's end. In favor of Isong Middle. Isong Middle going up, passes it to Benwoski in the center. Going up, tries to pass for number 12. Anthony Forrest, but doesn't seem to follow through. And another bouncy puck to the Minichog goalie. Easy save. Seems Isong Meadow is trying to switch up their lines to see, you know, what's going to work tonight against Minichog. Face off in Minichog's end. Favor of Minichog, but can't seem to find the puck. Pass to Mike Trace, shot, and it is saved. Face off. Isong Meadow's end. Benwoski can't seem to control the puck, but he jumps in at the end. Minichog gets the puck, passes it around the net. Seems something has fell on the ice. I'm not sure what, but Isong Meadow with the puck, still struggling in the end. Shot, and it is saved. It was a shot by Anthony Forrest. Looks like Isong Meadow's found something. I think, you know, the passing needs to be a little bit better, but it's just the start of the game. It's a Saturday afternoon, so.
Good sign that all these face-offs are on the left side of the rink.
Yeah, it is. Good. It's a good sign that they're on Minichog's end. More opportunities for the Spartans. Shot. Saved. Another shot. Oh. Goes behind the net. Minichog's Cam Mariani going up. That is back to Isong Meadow. Passes it back and forth. It's dumped down. Minichog racing to get the puck. On the boards, getting the puck. Pass to Isong Meadow, number 14. Nick Corbin has it around the net to Paulalamo. Paulalamo goes up. Tries to self-pass, gonna race for the puck, but it seems Minichog will hit it. Passes it back, and it's going down. Mike Trace controls the puck. Almost over the netting of the boards, but seems to be iced. So faceoff will be on East Longmeadow's end.
The Spartans could be struggling more offensively because of Wosky and Corbin just added new lines they have to work with.
Yeah, that's very true. Face off in favor of East Longmeadow. Jacob Bates controls the puck behind the net. Big hit on the boards by Griffin Trace. It's cleared back down to East Longmeadow, and East Longmeadow tries to bring it back up. Sort of confusion, loss of the puck, but Minichog loses it in their end, or East Longmeadow's end. It's going kind of going just back and forth right now. Believe it was an offsides.
Who do you think is going to score the first goal?
By the looks of it right now, I think East Longmeadow might. They've seemed to control the puck better in Minichog's end. But, you know, with these games, anything could happen. And Jack O'Brien, delay of game. I don't think they're going to count that as a penalty. But it hit the out-of-bounds netting, so face-off in East Longmeadow's end. And in favor of East Longmeadow once again. Seems in the beginning they were struggling, but I think they've found their East Longmeadow with the puck. I think Cormac Hayes is playing tonight. He's a freshman. Yes, Cormac, yep. Doing pretty good throughout the game. I've seen him a little bit more. Cormac's on a line. Cormac's on the first line, I believe. Alongside with Anthony Forrest and Ben Wosky.
Good experience for the future.
Yeah, very good. Minichog has the puck. It's going up. I could have called it earlier, and that was an offsides.
Minichog a little more aggressive right now.
A little more aggressive, yep.
You'd still think you'd expect more from a team that scored 8 goals last game.
Yes, true. East Longmeadow has the puck. Little scramble on the boards. Big hit by number 8 on East Longmeadow. Michael Trace. It's getting a little scrappy around here. Minichog with the puck. There's what was a 3-on-2. There was a shot saved by Jacob O'Brien. A little mishap, but covers it up for a face-off in East Longmeadow's end. East Longmeadow with the puck, but Minichog clears it back, and a weird bounce onto the netting.
Sometimes that goes in, but not all the time.
Yeah.
Even in the NHL.
Yep. Face-off won by Minichog. Minichog trying to find a flow in there in East Longmeadow's end to see if they can get any shots on goals or anything. It looks like it's Minichog's first line. But East Longmeadow has the puck. In Minichog again. Battle on the boards. Still struggling. Minichog right now has the puck control. Passes it up. Nick Corbin passes it to Jacob Bates. And Bates with a big hit. Bates just got hit. And it looks like what's going on right now. A very, very confusing, scrappy game right now. But it seems that they're trying to find their... Ooh! Ah, yeah. Xavier Facchini, number 15 for East Song Meadows. Looks like he's going to the box. A little bit more than what he should have done.
After a while, when you don't score any goals, you start to get a little more feisty.
A little more antsy. And this team has a history. Face-off won by Minichog. And shot by Minichog. And it seems to be a weird save. But it's back to Minichog. East Long Middle needs to... needs to be a little bit more aggressive right now. Needs to try to get that puck. Big hit on the boards by Griffin Trace. But there seems to be... I actually don't know what just happened right there.
I guess very confusing, like
yeah,
you said.
Yeah, there's a lot of confusion. All right, so it looks like Minichog has a penalty, so it's going to be a 4-on-4. There's a man in each box for each side. I guess it was a tripping penalty. I think Xavier Facchini is in there for roughing or interference or something like that. But face off on Minichog's end. And in favor of East Long Meadow. Shot wide. I believe intentional. And chase for the puck. I'm just going to let it go. Another face-off on Minichog's end. And in favor of East Long Meadow. Quick shot. Bouncy puck. But Paul Alamo has the puck, tries to pass it in the center, see if there's anything there. Keeps it on their end. Anthony Forrest with the hustle. Here comes Ben Waski, trying to maneuver around. But Minichog gets it one-on-one. East Long Meadow is struggling for their defense, but seems to dump it. And big hit by Minichog on Paul Alamo. Waski controls the puck. Self-pass on the boards. But it looks to seem that there's a shot by Minichog. Too high. And East Long Meadow needs to just calm down and get their thing going. Okay. Here comes Xavier Facchini out of the box. And dances around him. Tries to pass in the center. See if there's something there, but nothing. Shot from the blue line, and there's a 3-on-1 by Minichog, and he's just trying to block the passing lane. But here comes East Long Meadow rushing up, tries to pass it over. It's a 5-on-1, just dumps it in, and a bad bounce, and just saved by Jack O'Brien. East Long Meadow coming up. And another big hit. And another big hit. Nick Corbin. There's just so many hits tonight. And another big hit. Dumped down. Jacob Bates passes it up to Zach Martin. Zach Martin to Angelo. And another big hit on the boards. Minichog has the puck on their end. Minichog coming up. And another dump. Seems like they do that more often with Sydney's bounces tonight. Anything could happen. And it's shot wide. Minichog still has control of the puck. And a shot. Weird shot. Minichog just having so much room to do things. Isong Meadows just bunched right into their goalie. It just keeps getting more and more exciting. And it looks like number 17 on Isong Meadows, Zach Martin, is going in the box. I didn't see a penalty, but we'll find out what that is in a second.
Minichog is suddenly just taking over offensively. I don't understand it. Playing a little more rough, I guess, more hits.
Yeah. Win by Minichog, but Isong Meadow seems to get it. There's a pass in the center, and he tries to shoot it, and it just saved over his shoulder. Minichog has the puck. Passes it up off the boards. Tries to dangle through his legs, but misses, and a dumping shot on Minichog's, one of Minichog's men. Minichog controls the puck. Shot, and this deflected off the defender. Isong Meadow suddenly gets the puck, hit into the goalie. And I think that would be a penalty on Minichog's side. I think hit from behind, I think that's what they're going to call. It's Minichog's Anthony Pidio.
Big loss for them.
Yes. High sticking, that's what it was.
Seems so that Minichog always gets it 4-on-4 after getting the power play.
Yeah.
Not what they need.
Yeah, so it's a 4-on-4, and it looks like Minichog is going to have the favor on the face-off. They're in Isong Meadows' end. Pass, shot, and broke his stick. Rushing to get another one. And Isong Meadows goes up. Dances around the defender, Mike Trace. Minichog gets it back. Minichog going up. And shot, a big, powerful shot. Saved by Jack O'Brien.
Perfect timing on the part of the broken stick, though. That could have been
That could have been something, yeah.
He had a huge open lane there, and
yeah.
Stick just broke. Happens sometimes.
Even on 4-on-4s, man-to-man is good. Shot by Minichog. Won the face-off, and Jack O'Brien saves that with the glove. Jack O'Brien, Isong Meadow's goalie, has been doing good tonight. Face-off won by Isong Meadow. Cormac Hayes passes it to Ben Wosky, and it seems to be an offside. Right now, it's Ben Wosky, Cormac Hayes, Anthony Forrest, D-man Jacob Bates, and Mike Leahy. Seems to be the line they've in favor of tonight. Ben Wosky comes up, tries to shoot, and just missed. Just saved by the goalie, right on the shoulder. Isong Meadow with the puck. Wosky dumps it. Number 7, Jacob Bates, retrieves it. And tried to be cleared by Minichog, but Isong Meadow tries it. So there's the first, and a you know, from the start, it didn't look like there was going to be much, but it got rough, and it went on, and there was more shots, and it seemed that Isong Meadow had, I think Isong Meadow had more time on Minichog's end, but towards the end of the third, or towards the end of the first, Minichog was in Isong Meadow's end more.
We chose the wrong goalie to mess with, though, in Jack O'Brien.
Yeah, Jack O'Brien's a pretty good performance tonight. For the first, he was just lots of saves, had trouble with bouncing pucks. But Minichog's goalie was good, too. There was a couple shots that were high and good saves on the shoulders. And both goalies are doing good tonight, but trying to find that goal.
That rhythm?
That rhythm, yeah. I think they found it. It's just, you know, they got to pursue it. They got to find it. You know, they're going to make it last. That's what I'm trying to go to.
Today's game is brought to you in part by the Real Estate Market Center, located on North Main Street in East Long Meadow. Whether you are thinking of buying or selling a home, please consider calling Michael Roby at the Real Estate Market Center.
This game is also brought to you by Holly's Auto Repair. Full service repairs on foreign and domestic cars and complete auto service. That's Holly's Auto Repair, located on Shaker Road in East Long Meadow.
And welcome back. Here comes the second period. 12 minutes on the penalty. Anthony Pidio still in the box. And faceoff goes to Minichog. Minichog dumps it in Isong Meadow's end. Number 4, Paul Lemo retrieves the puck. Tries to self-pass. Succeeds. Anthony Forrest comes up with the puck. Passes behind him to Mike Trace, but Minichog retrieves the puck, but back to Isong Meadow, and I'm not sure what just happened.
A lot of things going on. Tough to see.
Yeah. All right, well, face off in Isong Meadow's end. I think it'd probably be an offside or something. I'm not sure. But face off won by Minichog. But Isong Meadow comes up with the puck. Freshman Cormac Hayes tries to battle for the puck to get that breakaway, but broken up by Minichog's defense. Minichog goes up. Big hit by Minichog on Mike Trace. And it is rowdy. It is rowdy.
Hits always get the crowd into the game.
And with this history, it's tough to tell, but it looks like Minichog drew a penalty. And there's a penalty. It's a good penalty for Isong Meadow to score that goal that they needed. Another penalty kill by Minichog. Hopefully it doesn't get that trend on a 4-on-4. Got to leave the pass behind them and try not to be as rough as they want to be. So I guess it's an interference call and number 4 is Minichog. Isong Meadow wins the faceoff in Minichog's end. Seems to be a little bit antsy with the puck. Tries to clear it, but just, I believe, hit the ref. Isong Meadow with the puck. Isong Meadow's Griffin Trace. Plenty of room. Number 4, Paul Alamo. Back to Griffin Trace. Passes it wide of the net. Tries to put it in front to see what's happening, but I guess nothing there. Back with it. Minichog gets the puck. Goes up. Passes to the centerman. And almost another one. Almost another breakaway. Save by Minichog, but I think they call them offsides. I didn't see one there, but whatever. Oh, another penalty. Penalty on Minichog for roughing, I believe. So two men in Minichog's box. So I guess we weren't going to get that 4-4 trend. So a 5-on-3. Face-off won by Isong Meadow and right between the legs of Paloalamo. Paloalamo has the puck, trying to regroup. Dumps it down in the end. 14, Nick Corbin battles on the boards. Still battling. Nick Corbin comes in with assistance, but it's a 2-on-2 battle on the boards. And Mike Trace with a shot, but saved by Minichog's goalie. Good saves between both goalies tonight.
I have a feeling that with all these face-offs the Spartans are winning, that's going to result in the first goal.
Yeah, I think so too. And I think they're doing a good job. Another face-off, won by Isong Meadow. Waiting for the D-men to go up, but not right now, I guess. So it's now in a 5-on-4, only one man in the box. 37 seconds left in the penalty. Cormac Hayes with the puck, passes it to Ben Waske. Ben Waske tries to go in the front, but goes around the net instead. Paloalamo with the puck, passes it in the front. Tries to pass in the center for Cormac Hayes, but nothing there. Paloalamo with the puck back to Waske. Centers it, and oh, so close. Cormac Hayes with the shot in the middle, in the center, but just missed. Another pass in the center. Isong Meadow trying to find the shot. Penalty's over. Another pass in the middle, but another save by Minichog's goalie. And what a night. What a night for the goalie. Good saves all around. Good opportunities for Isong Meadow to score that goal. But penalty's off, and it's back to 5-on-5.
Goalie's not given too much space in the net either. They're leaving open shots.
Face-off won by Minichog. Minichog goes around the net. Passes it up, and it looks like Minichog's got their stride going. Going up right in front of the net and almost crosses it. Shot by Minichog wide of the net. Isong Meadow recovers the puck. Griffin Trace, that is. And passes it to Xavier Ficini in Minichog's end, but Minichog retrieves it. Kind of back and forth. So Minichog offsides. And seems everyone's not happy with some of the offsides called tonight, but so face off in Isong Meadow's favor. Mike Trace passes it to number 4 Paloalamo, and Zach Martin coming up passes it to Angelo Morris, but another offside. Most of the offsides tonight has just been passing in the middle of the blue line, you know, people ahead of them, but it's just too late. That foot crosses before, and you know, that's
gotta get the upper hand somehow.
Yep, and a very high flip of the puck to try to dump it, but hits the ceiling. And so face off in Minichog's end. This line's been out here for a little bit, but seems to be in Minichog's favor, but big hit. Isong Meadow gets the puck back, waits for Isong Meadow to be on sides, but Angelo tries to get it back, and it's just going back and forth, and finally dumps it down, so Minichog gets the puck back. And big hit by Zach Martin. And another big hit by Zach Martin on the same guy. But pass in the middle again. I think that's what they're trying to do, is trying to find that goal. It's just passing in the center. And Minichog tries to clear it, but East Long Meadow gets it back. East Long Meadow's Mike Trace dumps it into Minichog's end. Minichog with the puck, but comes back to the freshman, Cormac Hayes. Avoids that hit, turns it over. Minichog tries to get the puck in East Long Meadow's end. Big hit on the boards, battling for that puck, but. Seems to be icing, I believe. So, a face-off of Minichog's end. A lot of opportunities for East Long Meadow. Good pace. I think they've seen to find their lines to use tonight. A clear. And Jacob Bates and Anthony Pidio trying to. And that's a goal. No goal. It's called off. I think a goalie interference would probably be the reason to call it off. But it's getting a little rough right now. Refs are discussing. What happened, East Long Meadow hit one of the players from Minichog, ran into the goalie. Goalie off his stance, bounce, balance, you know, and goalie interference is called. So I think they're going to stick with the no goal with 9 minutes left of the second period. So face off in East Long Meadow's end. And you can tell that the Minichog fans are not happy with that call. Face off won by East Long Meadow. Minichog gets it back, but back to East Long Meadow. Waits for someone to be onside for Minichog, but back and forth it goes. So Minichog comes up with the puck. Shot wide. Mike Trace passes it up, tries to clear it, dump it up. But here comes Anthony Forrest with the pass to Ben Wasky. Ben Wasky going up. Got to chase the puck. Anthony Forrest with the puck. Scramble on the boards. Scramble. Two. Minichog has the puck. Passes it up. Back to East Long Meadow. Minichog with the puck. Shot. Saved by Jack O'Brien. And East Long Meadow comes up. Griffin Trace and Xavier. Passes Xavier in the front. And just misses. The puck's loose. And chases it. It's some of the Minichog. Jack O'Brien comes out of the net.
Wow. O'Brien. Right. Never see a goalie do that.
Yeah. And. Oh. Saved by Minichog. Number six, I believe, Saraceno. And there's a big scrap. It's a pretty feisty game tonight. But yet again, penalty by Minichog. Probably roughing or something like that. But there's another opportunity for East Long Meadow besides the opportunities without the penalty. It went from one breakaway to another.
Getting closer to a goal.
Yeah, very close. They're both, you could say, fiending for a goal. But with this history, it's starting to get very scrappy. Minichog wins the faceoff. Going up, self pass, gets it, tries to battle, gets it back in their end. But Isong Metal, Griffin Trace, tries to get the puck back. Here comes Paul Alamo with the puck, tries to get in the front, dumps it down Minichog's end, behind the net. Xavier Ficini has the puck, but now back to Griffin Trace. Shot! Scored by Isong Metal! Griffin Trace! What a goal.
He's been hot.
He's been on fire the past two games. That's his third goal of the season.
In two games.
Yeah. Good performance. That was a nice goal. So, face off. Minichog's favor. Minichog dumps up high. No, it was not called. Minichog has the puck. Shot in the front, but saved. Jacob Bates tries to control with the puck on the boards. Getting tossed around. Here comes Xavier Ficini. Griffin Trace with the puck. Tries to self-pass, but just dumps it for a line change. Minichog with the puck, and there is a offsides. It was a pretty clear offsides. But some of the fans still don't like it.
You have to have complete control of the puck.
Yeah, and he passed it with his foot behind the blue line when his line mate was in front of him. So Spartans had those opportunities and finally got that goal. Minichog dumps it up and to the centerman and score, but shot saved, well, blocked by Isong Metal defender. Isong Metal tries to control the puck, but high stick, I believe. They're not calling them, I guess. So face off in Minichog's favor. Shot by the blue line. Deflected on their own man. But good blocking. Good pass block. Whatever you call it. mishap of words tonight.
For goals too.
So face off in Isong Metal's end. In favor of Minichog, passes to number four Minichog, and a big hit on Minichog's number four. Nick Corbin gets a pass in the front but can't control it. And back to Minichog, but dumps it and back to Isong Metal, so just waiting for some action, but it's just going back and forth right now. But and number 17, Zach Martin with that hit onto the helmet. I don't know what they're going to call it, but because the helmet came up slightly off of Minichog's men, will be going to the box. So Minichog has the puck. Minichog. Shot. Save by Jack O'Brien. Minichog still has the puck. Gets back on Isong middle side. Tries to find that flow, but and it's they're doing a good job. Shot by Anthony Pidio, saved by O'Brien. Chase for the puck. Minichog has it. Passes it up. And they're back in Isong middle zone. Minichog with the puck, passes to Anthony Pidio. Shot by number two, Minichog, and deflected in front. Deflected wide of the net. Here comes Ben Woski. Pass it back to Anthony Forrest with the backhand and just wide of the net. Just wide of the net. Battle on the boards for the puck. Minichog gets it. Passes it. Minichog passes in the front. And the net goes loose. A lot of complaining tonight. Probably loud enough that you could probably hear in our mics, but let's hope you don't.
Hopefully not catching everything.
Yeah.
Losing 1-0 is always frustrating.
Yep. But 1-0, Isong Metal faced off on Isong Metal's end and in favor of Isong Metal, but Minichog gets it back and no offsides call, but it's okay. In this front and a little bit of scrappiness going on right now. And that's all you're really seeing tonight. A lot of face-offs. Not a lot of that flow you're going to see, but... Minichog's Tyler Rose passes it up, and Isong Middle gets the puck back. Griffin Trace tries to dance around the defender, but Minichog gets back the puck. Minichog in the zone. Shot saved by Jack O'Brien. And Isong Middle gets the puck back. A battle on the boards. Keeps it onside for Minichog, but goes back offsides. And Griffin Trace comes up. Griffin Trace. Shot. But deflect by the defender. Isong Middle's like Mike Leahy. Passes it up, but Minichog gets it back. Minichog gets it offsides, but Mike Leahy and Minichog tries to get the puck free, but and he does, goes offside, so Minichog gets back the puck. Isong Middle with the puck. Self pass, but Minichog has it. Anthony Pidio going up. Turnover by Isong Meadow. Dumps it behind the net. Isong Meadow's Paul Lama has some wide open space to shoot. And deflected. Number 14, Nick Corbin, has the puck on the boards. Passes it in front for... Angelo, but misses it and a big hit. Another shot, wide of the net. I believe intentionally, Zach Martin tries to get the puck on the boards, but doesn't get it. Mike Trace trying to avoid the offsides, but dumps it behind the net on Minichog's end. Isong Meadow with the puck, dumps it back. Minichog has it. Trying to find that flow. Anthony Pidio shot and just over the net. Isong Meadow with the puck. Ben Wasky goes up. Backhand in the front, nothing there. Cormac Hayes dumps it behind the net. Isong Meadow tries to keep it on sides, and it is. Paloma gets the puck. Battle on the boards, but seems to be a face-off on the other end, on Isong Meadow's end. So it's that flow we've been talking about all game. And they're just trying to find it, just like the last period. Minichog shot, bouncy puck, but goes right into the glove of Jack O'Brien. Face off, Isong Meadow end. In favor of Minichog, and a goal by Minichog. Not what Isong Meadow wanted to see, I'll tell you that. Goal by Cam Mariani. Super 7. I'm not sure if that's his first goal of the season, but it sure is an important one for this game. Face-off won by Isong Meadow. A little bit of confusion between Isong Meadow, but seems to control it. Griffin Trace coming up on the boards. Griffin Trace with a shot. Goal by Griffin Trace! And off, just like that, goes right back to Isong Meadow. That's two goals for Griffin Trace. That's four goals in two games. And Minichog is very upset. But, wow. What a response.
Well, trick shot. Yeah, off the back of his
helmet. Oh, yeah. Goalie didn't even see it. Goalie felt it on his back, and it just rolled right in. It's a tough angle, too. Like, what a goal. But Isong Meadow has the puck. Tries to pass in the center. And it, for my angle, it looked like it was going in. But battle on the boards. Big hit. Shoots it in front, and here comes Minichog. But the end of the period. I mean, what a response. Goal in the beginning, nothing in the middle, nothing. And then at the end, you see Minichog with that response, and then Isong Meadow with a better response.
Well, the Cranston goal, that was Luke Cranston who scored for Minichog. I thought that was going to set the tone, and then Griffin Trace just staying hot.
Yep.
Finding every angle.
All right. Well, we're going to have a 10-minute intermission, and we'll be right back.
Today's game is brought to you in part by the Real Estate Market Center, located on North Main Street in East Long Meadow. Whether you are thinking of buying or selling a home, please consider calling Michael Roby at the Real Estate Market Center.
This game is also brought to you by Holly's Auto Repair. Full service repairs on foreign and domestic cars and complete auto service. That's Holly's Auto Repair, located on Shaker Road in East Long Meadow.
Looking for the latest news in East Long Meadow? Tune into LCAT News for updates on what's happening inside town government, up-to-the-minute information on local events and breaking news. Check out LCAT 01028 on YouTube.com or tune in each night at 7 p.m. on channel 191. LCAT News Update for all the news you need to know. And don't forget, you can watch our complete lineup of LCAT sports anytime on any device by watching LCAT's YouTube channel, LCAT 01028. Subscribe to our page to stay up to date with sports games, meetings, concerts, and town events. All available wherever you are, whenever you want. That's LCAT 01028 at YouTube.com. If you're a local business owner, you should consider supporting LCAT's coverage of sports here in East Long Meadow by becoming an underwriter of our very popular sports programming. Choose from 3-month packages up to a full year and let our viewers know that you support our teams and LCAT's commitment to share their achievements within the East Long Meadow community. To learn more about how you can become an underwriter with surprisingly affordable introductory packages, contact Sports Director Jamie Rook at 413-525-4220.
All right, welcome back. It's a good break for East Long Meadow and Minichog. Coaches talking to them, telling them what they need to do to either maintain the lead or make it bigger. Need to work on what they were struggling. I could tell you, offsides maybe. Their penalty kill. I mean, their face-offs too. Maybe getting goals on the penalty. Definitely a huge thing was the, you could say, chirping, the scrappiness, the physical, to try to avoid it, because you don't want to have stupid penalties. So
a lot more anxiety in the third period.
Yeah. 2-1 East Long Meadow, and you know, you saw Minichog score that goal, so they can do it, and they know how to do it. You know, it's all timing. So we got Cormac Hayes, Anthony Forrest, Ben Wasky, Paul Lamo, and Mike Trace. And face-off goes to Minichog's end. Dumps it in the East Long Meadow's end. East Long Meadow's Ben Wasky has the puck. Paul Lamo dumps it behind the net. Minichog. Minichog trying to pass it up, but East Long Meadow has the puck. Ben Wasky tries to pass in front of the net, but Minichog has it. Minichog with the puck, dumps it in, and Jack O'Brien saves it.
Surprise, surprise.
So, face-off, East Long Meadow end, and goes in favor of East Long Meadow. Passes it to Xavier Ficini. Race for the puck. Griffin Chase receives it. Passes it down. And Minichog with the puck. Going up 3-on-2. And easy save by Jack O'Brien. Shots on goal today. 19 for Minichog and 17 for East Long Meadow.
Very strong shots, though.
Yeah.
For Minichog.
A lot of strong shots on Minichog. A lot of, I think you could say, harder saves for Jack O'Brien than the Minichog goalie. Minichog with the puck. Passes in the front, and a goal by Minichog. Another goal by Minichog, number 10. There's two goals for him. It's just each team. Two goals for number 10 on Minichog, two goals for Griffin Trace, 19.
Well, if you keep putting shots in that, they're bound to go in, so.
Yep. Minichog with more shots, 20. But East Long Meadow gets the puck, passes in front. Number 14, Nick Corbin, passes it back to number 9, Angelo, and broken up 3-on-2 from you know, 3-on-2. 3 Minichog, 2 Isong Meadow, but Isong Meadow has the puck in Minichog's end. Minichog clears it back, and Mike Trace dumps it behind the net. Minichog with the puck passes in front. Dances. And another shot by Minichog, saved by Jack O'Brien. There was almost another goal by Minichog. And right in the front, and phew. Isong Meadow with the puck. And another shot by Minichog, saved by Jack O'Brien. It's that flow again, and it's not on either side. It keeps going back and forth. It's like half of the period to Minichog flow, and then the other half is Isong Meadow, and then you get those little tidbits in the middle that you kind of back and forth, and right now it seems to be in favor of Minichog. Jacob Bates behind the net. Broken up by Minichog. Minichog with a shot from the blue line. Deflect and just saved. Dumped up. Cormack trying to race for the puck. Number 16 on Isong Meadow, but Minichog has the puck. But battle on the boards for the puck, but Jacob Bates dumps it up. And Ben Wasky comes up to try to get the puck. Drops his stick. Isong Meadow with the puck again. And Minichog back with it. Minichog with a good pass in front. And another goal by Minichog. Isong Meadow needs to be more aggressive, I think. Minichog 3, Isong Meadow 2. It's pretty early, so a lot could happen. Time on the clock, 11:50. Number 6, Joe Siracino, comes up with the puck. Tries to control, dances around the defender. Number 4, Paul Alamo, deflects off a skate. Griffin's traces skate. Goes in front, but Minichog gets the puck back. Minichog with a shot. Easy save by Jack. Griffin Trace tries to dump it up, but gets it right back and offsides. Didn't see Xavier trying to race back, but another offside tonight. Face off, Isong Meadow's win. Jacob Bates dumps it, goes behind the net. Minichog has it, passes it up, and Isong Meadow back with it. Nick Corbin battling on the boards. Isong Meadow gets it back. Jacob Bates passes it back to Zach Martin, but misses it. And Minichog with it, and another in a wide open pass. But seems to be an offsides or something like that. So Isong Meadow still with no shot on goal today, or in the period, sorry. Trying to find that. Tries to pass it in front, but Minichog gets it back, and here's a one-on-one. And broken up, no trip. Hit the puck before it hit the skate. A lot of complaints.
I think they called it.
Oh, I guess they do call it.
It's just delayed.
Yeah, it's delayed penalty. You know, I don't think it was a tripping. I think the rule is if the stick hits the puck before it, you could say hits the player, then it's not a tripping. But if it hits the player before it hits the puck, then he trips and falls or whatever. But Mike Trace is in the box. That's a big loss for their defense. But we got Anthony Forrest coming up. 2-on-1 shot saved by Minichog.
The key for the Spartans is to find another goal scorer besides Trace. And that guy was Ficini in the first game. He scored 2.
Yep. Yeah, we can't rely on people this year. We got to have a better team, you know, better chemistry. And, you know, the chemistry is pretty good. It's just, you know, it's only 2 games, so we'll definitely see some more. I mean, there was a huge opportunity for Cormac Hayes, a freshman, earlier in the game, so we'll definitely see a lot from him. But Minichog gets the puck, passing in the front, shot, deflected off of a defender's skate. Minichog still has the puck, passes to number 12. Shot wide, almost, I think it was a pass, but dumped. 40 seconds on the penalty clock. Isong Mills finally got that shot on goal, by the way. But Minichog comes up, takes his time around the net, passes in the front, nothing there. About 15 seconds left in the penalty. And just taking their time. No shot yet. But a shot and off of Benwoski and Xavier. And number 2 for Minichog is chasing it. Xavier tries to get it back and Mike is out of the box. Shot by Mike Leahy, but wide of the net. Well, that was a pretty good penalty kill by Isong Middle. Dumped it.
Minichog definitely cooled off at the right time, I guess you could say.
Yeah. They weren't making the passing lanes easy for Minichog, and that's good. I still think they should be a little bit more aggressive, but we'll see how the rest of the period goes. Shot by Minichog, saved by O'Brien off of his stick, his paddle, and that goes out of bounds. .820 left in the period. Minichog wants to face off and misses the shot. Jacob Bates recovers. Tries to pass it to Ficini, but didn't see it. Minichog with the puck. And O'Brien saves it. Covers it. For another faceoff on Isong Mills' end. 26 shots for Minichog, 18 for Isong Meadow. 8 minutes left in the third. 3-2 Minichog.
Surprisingly, only one of those 18 shots this period from Isong Mills.
Yeah. Faceoff won by Minichog. Isong Mills gets the puck, dumps it back, but Minichog dumps it right back to O'Brien. Good save. Easy save. And number 19, Griffin Trace, gets the puck. Tries to see if he can go past and does. Struggling with the puck, gets it on boards, passes in the front, nothing there. Brings it around, Paul Amo battles for it on the boards. Paul Amo trying to pass it, but Minichog being very aggressive. Michael Trace has the puck. Back, hands it back into Minichog's end. Minichog recovers. Minichog passes it back. And there is a 2-on-1 save by O'Brien.
probably should have came at closer to him a little more.
Yeah. But most of O'Brien's saves tonight seems powerful shot-wise. Glove. Either side of the net, either side of left or right wing, but face-off won by Minichog. Minichog behind Isong Mills. Net and pass in front, and what a save by O'Brien. Isong Mills recovers the puck. Angelo. Pass by Minichog. Minichog gets the puck back in Isong Mills' end. But Nick Corbin comes up. Nick Corbin covering it. Pass in front. Nothing there, but Jacob Bates with a shot. Almost deflected in. Goalie still doesn't have it, but I don't know what they just call it. I think goalie interference, but if that was not called, Zach Martin would have probably had the goal. Yeah, I'm going to say that was a goalie interference. Or a delay of game or something. It's hard to tell the calls. But face off in Minchog's end. More discussion from the refs. Discussing to Isong Mao's coach. Seems shocked, but it's a lot of back and forth talk, but won by Isong Meadow and shot by Corbin wide. Mike Trace gets it. And seemed onsides. And there's a lot of frustration. Chirping back from Anthony Pidio and Mike Trace. He was already in his windup when the whistle blew, but of course, you know, there's more talk and no game. Face-off won by Isong Meadow. Mike Trace recovers the puck. Pass it over to Paul Alamo. Paul Alamo passes to Zach Martin. Zach Martin passes it up to Nick Corbin right in front. Saved by Minichog and a lot of scrapping. In front of the net. Seems it's all it is after the whistle blows. Isong Mao starting to find that tempo. Good, you know, the face-off wins are important. Face-off from Minchog's end. In favor of Minichog. Minichog goes up with a puck. Pass in front, nothing there. Here comes Ben Woski, passes to Anthony Forrest. Anthony Forrest, shot, save. Anthony Forrest back with the puck. And tries to self-pass, but turns into a two-on-one. Jacob Bates all alone. And off the crossbar, almost in. Ben Woski to Cormac Hayes. To Jacob Bates. Dumps it. And right in front of the net. Oh, and Griffin almost had the hat trick. And I don't know what just happened, but more arguments between both teams and the ref. Minichog's bench. Pretty annoyingly. A lot of rowdy. Banging, rowdy, trying to get in Isong Mao's head, but 5 minutes left of the game, shots 22, Isong Mao, 28 minute chalk. And more hits, that's all you're seeing. And more delays of penalties. Minichog still getting rowdy. Not a lot of game playing again.
Griffin Trace, too, in the penalty box.
Yeah, it's a big loss. But face-off won by Minichok. Loss back to back and forth. And another hit. And I mean, I guess they'll call it this time. And kind of heard that trend of a, you know, that 4-on-4 in the first period and the second. And here it is. Cam Mariani with the penalty on Minichok.
That was just retaliation, not trying to win the game.
Retaliation is all you're going to see tonight between these two teams. But face off won by Isong Meadow. Mike Trace with the shot. Deflected by Minichok. Minichok going up. Mike Trace all alone, but Joe Cirasino comes up. Isong Meadow with the puck. Xavier tries to self-pass, gets it, and dumps it behind Minichok's net. Joe Cirasino comes up with the puck. Tries to dance around. And Joe is hurt. And Joe just got boarded into the... and there's a lot. Oh, no.
I don't know what they're doing. I mean, they're winning.
It's all it is. Roughing and everything. And Joe is hurt. Joe has not gotten up since. This is a hit from behind, a boarding call, easily a boarding call. I'm just waiting until he gets kicked out of the game, but.
I'm surprised nobody's been thrown out.
He'll probably be thrown out very soon. But it was a hit from behind. It was a boarding, and Joe's slowly getting up. A lot of talk between both benches, between coaches, between refs, between players. And that's all we've really seen in the past 3 minutes. So,
a little bit of rivalry.
Oh, a big a big rivalry.
Big as Long Meadow, though.
So, 5-minute penalty for East Long Meadow. See if we can get that goal to get back on the board. But still 57 seconds left for Isong Meadow to kill. But still, it's a 4-on-4 right now. Paolamo with the puck, passes in the front. And Minichok dumps it, clears it. So Mike Trace with the puck, passes it to Cormac Hayes. Oh, I'm sorry, not Cormac. Anthony Forrest. Mike with the puck. Passes it to Ben Wosky. Ben Wosky dances a shot. Saved by Minichok. And a little jab by Mike to get the puck. See if he can get it. But seems Joe's back into the bench. Yep, Joe's back. So I think he just got a little shooken up or something like that. But Mike with the shot. And almost deflects it in. Battle with the puck, but Ben Wosky gets it back. Ben Wosky passes it to Mike. And another shot by Mike just off the crossbar. And Cam Mariani is out of the box and a breakaway for him. And very wide of the net. Mike Trace has the puck. Pass it to Ben Wosky. Ben Wosky tries to pass it in front. Nothing there. Anthony Forrest battles the puck on the boards. Griffin Trace out of the box. So little bit ago. Had the puck. Jack O'Brien clears it back. Griffin back with the puck. Griffin tries to pass it to Anthony Forrest. Didn't see it. Mike Trace receives it. 2 minutes and 14 seconds left in the penalty and 2 minutes and 30 seconds left into the third period. East Hong Metal really needs to get that goal right now. Paul Alamo gets the puck. Tries to pass it to Griffin Trace. Griffin Trace has the puck. Griffin Trace shoots and just above the net. Jack O'Brien passes it up along the boards. Paul Alamo struggling to get the puck on the boards, but Mike Trace gets it back. 1 minute and 50 seconds left in the period. Pass it to Zach Martin. Zach Martin tries a self-pass, but goes offside. Zach Martin and dumped by Minichog, but comes back to Anthony Forrest. Zach Martin gets the puck. Zach Martin rushes up. Passes it to Mike Trace. Anthony Forrest has it now. Anthony Forrest shoots it. Saved by Minichog. So 1 minute and 19 seconds left into the third. 1 minute left in the penalty. 24 shots for East Hong Metal. 29 shots for Minichog. Really need to get that goal.
East Hong Metal doing better offensively, possibly because, you know, defending their teammates from all those hits.
Yeah. East Hong Metal sure stepping it up. Well, the next game is against Amesbury High. That's going to be in Veterans Memorial Hockey Rink. I'm not sure where that is, but I don't think we will be announcing that game. But well, after this game, they're definitely going to talk, get ready for the next. But right now, they really need to get another goal to get it back on the board. I'd love to see that. Show Minichog. Oh, face off in Minichog's end in favor of East Hong Metal. Nick Corbin has the puck, passes to Mike Trace. Mike Trace misses the shot. And Minichog dumps it. Mike Trace goes around. And tripped. And I believe they're going to call it. So tripping by number 17 on Minichog on Mike Trace, I think. I think they're going to call it, yeah. So there's another penalty for East Hong Metal. 58 seconds left in the third. 2 minute penalty, so let's see if they can do it. Let's see if they can do something. They've got too many men on the ice right now, so. Not sure where they're. Oh, I guess there's a timeout. So two men in the box for Minichog, 58 seconds left. Face off on Minichog's end. Face off in favor of Minichog. Tries to dump it, but deflected off Ben Wosky. Really trying to battle for the puck, but when Jack O'Brien tries to get the extra man, it seems he has to pass the puck. So here comes Nick Corbin. Corbin passes it to Mike Trace. Mike Trace back to Corbin. Wosky, sorry. Shot by Paul Alamo. Saved. Shot by Mike Trace and deflected off of Minichog and misses the empty net.
Oh.
That was a hard shot. They really need to, what are they doing? They really need to regroup. And Minichog wins the game. Well, Let's wrap that up. It was a rowdy game. Isong Meadow had it in the first, but a lot of aggressiveness, you could say, from both sides. Isong Meadow tried to respond but couldn't. So I think they should know what they need to work on for the next game. Definitely, you know, getting those scoring opportunities in the
lots of missed opportunities.
Yeah, a lot of missed opportunities, scoring opportunities and penalties too. They had plenty of those tonight, and hopefully they can do better next game. Mm-hmm. So, this is Alex Maserati.
And Jack Gagnon.
And we'll see you next time.